think as philosophers, we're very invested in what it means to give an account of a good life. And one of the doctors told us this, I think, really wonderful story.
I had a patient several years ago that was admitted for gastrointestinal bleeding. He was on a blood thinner, and he was put on this a few years after he had his heart valve replaced.
And so the doctor went to go check in on the patient, and the patient was staring out the window. And when the doctor asked them what was wrong, the patient answered that
he'd been lying there thinking about what they had done to him, as in put in this valve, put him on this medicine that he was stuck on for the rest of his life. And the whole time this was going through his head, he was looking out the window and watching the lights up on the hill blinking. And he got frustrated because
the blinking of the light was out of sync with the ticking of his mechanical valve, and then it was driving him insane.
And then he went on his way, and the surgery was a success, but for him, on some level, the whole thing was a disaster and it was a failure, because his life was now different in a way that he never had conceived was possible.
When the path isn't clear for a patient, when principles are in conflict, not so much my job to say, you know, this is the principle that we should be following. It's to help the family or the patient to understand, help them find their good, and then I can unpack that in terms that other people can understand.
Clinical ethics, it focuses on ethical problems that tend to emerge within a hospital setting. My class has nearly half of the students being human physiology majors and biology majors, and on the other hand, we have philosophy students that are doing a lot of work in the humanities in general.
One of the biggest criticisms I get about things like medical philosophy is that's not actually how it works, that's not how it's applied. Well, this class kind of takes that into consideration.
Feel free to dive in and, you know, we'll have this conversation.
I remember there was one meeting where I kind of just had to sit back and be like, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong in that kind of thinking that informed consent is what we should strive for as a medical society. And that was directly after a conversation with Dr. Raj Alexander.
Informed consent to me as a hospitalist, a practicing physician, is about getting into partnership with the patient so that they agree to the treatment that you're going to give them. They need to know what those effects are, why you're giving them to them, what the alternatives are, what the risks are, and then ideally they would say, yes, I want you to give me the medicine. Otherwise, it's all one-sided. It needs to be a partnership.
So one of the things that makes this class interesting is definitely the joint relationship between U of O and PeaceHealth. Being in a classroom on Tuesday, being in a hospital on Thursday, this partnership with PeaceHealth wouldn't have happened without the generous time and effort of John Holmes, who's the director of ethics.
I really am passionate about ensuring that students get that opportunity, because I just feel it was so important for my development, professionally and personally, and if I can just give even a little bit of that to another student, I've done my job.
John made it possible for myself and for three students to be part of an organ harvesting procedure. We found ourselves in the operating room, and we have witnessed the ways in which organs are harvested from a patient who was dead by brain criteria.
When you watch someone's chest being opened up, and when you watch the main artery of the heart being cut, and you see that the heart is still beating, and you see that this person is still so much a human.
Part of me as a human felt like, wow, that heart kept going. I mean, and I cannot shake that feeling. It reminds to all of us the extent to which we are finite beings.
There are just some times in medicine where things aren't going to go as you expect, and you're going to have to make hard choices. And helping the care team sort that out is really what a clinical bioethicist can do if they do it right and they do it well.
This class has done nothing but surprise me in that I feel like it's made me more passionate about my drive to practice medicine, and it's given me more skills, both rationally and morally, to help me combat difficult, you know, aspects of medicine.
It's really important to learn about value debates, and it's equally important to realize how those value debates translate into real life situations.